How about that 85 World Series, Stephen?
You weren't even born, buddy.
Yeah.
All right. And welcome into the Sports Timeout podcast brought to you by Jefferson's Free Fried Pickle Fridays and Robert's Integrative Dentistry in Joplin. If you're looking for a brighter, straighter smile, back at it. Tony's not here, so I won't get made fun of. But be sure to schedule your appointment today at 417-622-0404. Wes Underwood, Clint, Tony, Jensen, Jonah are out. But yeah, how are you?
Doing good. I like a two pod, makes it more intimate. We can really get into the details, and we will because we got some good topics.
Hey man, I like monopods or tripods. I don't know about a dual pod.
That's true.
Pod.
Dual pod is there's no way for it to stand. Yeah, there's no no point of it.
Look at the film industry in us there, you know.
Yeah.
All those practicums we had to take.
Yeah, none of them involved a dual pod.
So what's the point of this practicum? Just shut up and film the game. Oh, okay. or what was it? Judy Styles? Yeah. Shh.
Oh, yeah.
Quiet on the set. Yeah. What is she doing out there? She's hosting a show that none of you get to host, but you get to produce.
You get to film it. You get experience. Okay. Yeah. Holding the camera.
And then nobody's allowed to touch her set and all that stuff. Good times.
Good time. Hey, she might be listening. Judy, hey, I love you. I met you twice, probably. But,
Judy, I got my own studio now.
Yeah. So. Pretend like that's a lot behind you. Remember, I mean, Bill? What happened to Bill? I wonder if he's still there.
No, he's gone.
Oh, okay.
Shout out to Bill. He finally retired.
Retired.
I think everybody's gone out of there now, except for
probably,
Slavings.
Yeah.
Bryant? Ward's still there.
Yeah. Oh, Ward's there.
Livingston's at PSU.
Yep. That was like even while I was there, she moved there, I remember.
Yeah.
And then
left me high and dry my sophomore year.
Well, you're really letting it out for the, like, what if there's like a, what if they're having like a staff reunion? It's like, oh, here's Wes and Clint.
Yeah, whatever happened to that? Didn't we have like a chart staff reunion and then the KGCS softball game type thing?
Was there? I wasn't really part of either one invited. Enough to, I wasn't really part of one enough to really do that. Well, I was on my filming my own stupid stuff.
Do you know Mills?
Yeah, Nathan Mills.
Yeah.
He was
in charge of that. Once he left, I think it kind of broke.
That's probably
away.
What it was, yeah. He had more of like the Animal House kind of vibe to get those things going. And once he was
out, Mills,
kind of,
much respect. Dude's still here local, but he's doing stuff for St. Louis now. So
right on. For the newspaper
time.
And stuff.
Yeah.
Heck yeah.
Yeah. Good times. All right. Well,
that's your MSSU nostalgia update.
It's coming up on what, almost 10 years, somewhere around there, 2015.
Yeah, that's crazy. I graduated in 14.
So, well, this year's 10 years for you. Congrats.
Yeah, that's crazy. That feels weird to say. 10 years of college ending. But I think it's because I then went on to master's at Pepperdine, and that still felt like it almost felt like for me, we're really going off on a tangent here, but it almost felt like for me, Missouri Southern was like high school extended, because I knew so many. I'm from Mount Vernon, Missouri, and I knew so many Mount Vernon people there. So it's just like, now here's high school, except we have dorms and stuff. And so when I moved to California, that almost felt like your classic like college and school that you'd see. And I was there for like 5 years.
I mean, so we both had the TV side a little bit. And then on top of that, we had the choir thing going for us.
Yeah. Oh yeah. I had my foot in multiple. Like, there wasn't really one thing where it's like, ah, yes, Clint from the, you know, unless they saw my videos on YouTube.
Shout out to Granger.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I did band stuff. I did met them in music class. All kinds of things.
Good to Chris, good to Chris go. Tanksley.
Yep. Yep.
Yeah. Seneca,
fellow bass
choir director, I believe. Yeah.
Wow. That should be another segment we do, just like updates on like, remember this kid you saw maybe in Missouri Southern? Well, now he is the, you know, now he works as the assistant director for, you know, Spectrum.
Yeah, no joke.
Anyways.
But yeah, well, nice
let's
little tangent there. But before we continue and get started, hit that subscribe and follow button on YouTube.
Smash it.
But well, all right. fun talk over about MSSU. We'll go ahead and talk NFL now. And we talk New York Jets, Aaron Rodgers. Coach Saleh says quarterback Aaron Rodgers has put his torn Achilles behind him and has had no limitations while practicing in OTAs. I mean, we all saw at the end of the season, he started throwing again and everyone speculated he would start by season's end. They shut that down. It's out the window. Nobody cared after that. But yeah, I mean, kind of a Jets fan here for you. And kind of an adopted Jets fan now that we have Isaiah Davis there. But what are your thoughts on the rest of the season for him? And do you think we see Rodgers in a preseason game this year? Or do you think that's asking too much?
Oh, interesting. First of all, yeah, I hope anyone listening in Joplin, it'd be cool if you became Jets fan just for my sake. That'd be kind of fun just to be like, hey, we got a local kid who's on the Jets. And he was signed pretty quickly, too. So I feel like they like him. That wasn't like a, you know, we'll put him on the squad and see if he does good. It was like instantly they wanted him. Still could get cut after. Anyways. But yeah, I think Aaron Rodgers, I think he'll play a half in the preseason. I feel like he needs, now it might not be like the full playbook, but I feel like they need some kind of like build up before just going right back to game one again.
Yeah.
You know, or the game one where it happened last year, exact same, where it's going to be on Monday Night Football again, which is insane. it's like almost like deja vu. So you might be like, you know, just to make sure I'm a little bit more prepped and not.
Well, the Chiefs get the opening game this year. So.
Yeah. Okay. Of course. Hopefully next year too. But I think he will. And I'm kind of hoping it's a weird situation because I'm also a Mavericks fan, which we'll talk about later, but there was a very nice, like unexpected revelation of Kyrie Irving, because if you remember like 3 years ago, he basically was like rightfully so, like one of the most hated people in the NBA and just kept saying wrong things politically, kept not taking vaccinations and then would miss games and just would mess up his team because he just wouldn't play half the games. And it was very like, not very thoughtful. It's like, is he a good teammate? And then we got him and it's like, oh my gosh, and now he got this canker sore. And then it just completely flipped. Like, I'm not sure if it was a change of scenery or what, but he just like became a leader. He's more quiet. He lets Luka be the star. He just plays defense, like totally unexpected. And now he's helping his team to champ. So, and then him and Aaron Rodgers were kind of in a similar boat where it's like, we know the talent's there, but they're lost in this other world of politics and stuff. And so I'm hoping there's some kind of like, he kind of has a revelation of like, all right, now that I'm actually playing week to week, I'm going to stop doing the, you know, the back things that distract me. And he's just kind of a nice football player who's helpful of his teammates.
I mean, he hasn't really been on Pat McAfee this offseason, so I think he kind of
took a good start.
Yeah, because I mean, last year when he was rehabbing, he was on there almost every week.
Yeah.
He was talking about it and all that stuff. And I'm just kind of like, so does he take the offseason? Like, is he going to do his retreat of darkness again this year? What?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I think that's what it was. It felt like this, the past few months, and then hopefully this summer, it feels like he's more serious about it.
Yeah.
So we'll see.
Well, I mean, Zach Wilson's out of there now too, so he doesn't have that guy staring him down like, I'm coming for your job.
Exactly. Yeah, I love our, that's the other thing too, but I mean, I guess we're kind of on Jets corner, but like, we're really well done constructed team this year. So it's not like we need Aaron Rodgers to save us. It's just like, if he can be a decent quarterback, kind of, I mean, he was really bad, but not too dissimilar to like Peyton Manning when he won with the Broncos. Again, he was really like an old man throwing with nothing, but even if that was that situation where it's like, he's not a distraction, he doesn't throw interceptions, and he can help us win games, then it's like, the Jets might be sneaky, like, pretty good.
Absolutely.
So, yeah, I hope he plays.
Same here. I mean, I guess I'm okay with him playing in the preseason, but like you said, I mean, I don't foresee it going past maybe a half. I mean,
right. Yeah.
For me, honestly, I don't even see anything past four downs, like 1, 2, 3. Oh, series. Okay, you're out.
Yeah,
good job.
Or one drive. Nice job. Yeah, one drive. That's possible too.
So we'll see.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree. Next up in the NFL, we go ahead and talk Rashee Rice. Oh, a lot going on here. I'm not even really sure about what's truthfully going on because there's just a lot to unfold.
Well, we got good news today, which is, I mean, good news in terms of the Chiefs. You know, I'm not sure if it's good news in terms of whatever was happening, but the added photography punching fiasco, supposed, like, we don't know, was dropped by the
affidavit
by the state, technically. which means that that is just gone. So that's pretty big news, actually. I mean, I think people kind of assume that like this probably was, but like we're assuming there's going to be a 6 to 7 game suspension already for the driving thing.
And then I mean, since he turned himself in and everything, like they said that he wasn't cooperating, but I feel like he cooperated that whole time. He was like, I'm going to turn myself in. Then they issue the warrant the next day, and then he's like, dude, I'm already coming. Like, hold your horses.
Oh, for the car thing?
Yeah, for the cars.
Yeah, I think it was just part of the statement will be the fact that he somewhat walked away from the car. Yeah. I think that's what it was, as that was the not complying, because you should just stand there and get your insurance out or whatever. But you know, he's young and he'd blow whatever.
I mean, he probably had a gun on him.
Yeah, there was probably, I think he got out of the car to make it, but then he admitted that he was driving, the whole thing.
Yeah.
That aside, that one we already kind of know. It's like, it's not going to be, I mean, seriously doubt it's going to be, he's like out for the season. We know it's going to be.
I honestly see less than that. Yeah, I think he'll appeal and I think he can win. I mean, as long as he does the right thing from here on out, well, I think he'll be fine. Hopefully. I honestly see it going 4 games.
We'll see. I wonder if, like, even though he didn't get, even though it was all dropped, I wonder if the fact that he was involved in another thing makes it seem like, yeah, maybe he hasn't learned. We just need to make a point here that you can't just be an idiot and they'll make it 8 games. I imagine 6 to 8 games still. So we'll see. Yeah. But nonetheless, it's still good news, though, because for all we knew, it was going to be like, yes, he did punch a photographer. Now that guy has head injuries. And now it's like, you know, he could be like, we have to drop Rashee Rice. You know, it's like something really terrible. So that was good news that it's like, It was dropped enough that it wasn't something like behind the scenes where we get a tweet, you know, that pops up. It's like huge news. The guy is that he did punch is in the hospital, and this is like a huge. He's going to be dropped by the Chiefs, and you know, it's like the Kareem Hunt thing, and it's like, whoa.
Like,
so the fa-
okay.
We'd probably see.
I got you. I'm taking notes.
That'd probably be followed by like the Chiefs have traded for DJ Metcalf with.
Oh my God.
With multiple firsts because they're desperate to. Anyways. So yeah, I'm glad that happens, because at least theoretically, by the time we ramp up for the playoffs, we will have Rashee Rice, Xavier Worthy, and Hollywood Brown. So that's all theored up. Just like he's at OTA. So just like, man, dude, just play video, you know, as everybody's been saying, just play video games. If he doesn't play video games, you know, watch Dragon Ball Z, watch whatever your hobby is, but just not another thing where you use your anger from the last thing, which my bet is what happened. Maybe not, but my bet could is it was some kind of photo that, and he was tired of all this hubbub, and he just kind of, you know, let something out, but it wasn't actually physical. Who knows? But so just like let it, like that was in the past. I'm young. Now I have a chance to be on a rare Chiefs team. It's like could get a three-peat, and it's like, this is an all-time opportunity. That's not just your decent receiver. So there's no sense in like, now, also, I have to be the cool friend who buys Lamborghinis and drives her. It's like, don't do that. So I think we should be okay, so that was great news today, even though he still has a suspension looming.
Absolutely. Next up in the NFL, electronics is something that you brought up there, and we're going to continue that route. And electronic refereeing coming into the league this preseason. And I mean, if it goes well, I mean, that could be the thing to determine whether you get a first down or not. I mean, officials are still going to be in there to determine if, you know, players are committing penalties and whatnot. But first down marker, I don't know. I mean, we'll see how it goes in the preseason, but don't they kind of already go there with, like, if it's a big play and they send it up to replay, and replay is pretty much AI. I mean, you got the guy up there just looking back at it, and then is he there? Is he not there? Is the knee down? Is it not down?
Yeah, that's a good point.
I don't know.
I'm wondering if they're thinking, yeah, it is that, and that's why we should just do it electronically, because we're basically, we're spending 20 minutes going upstairs looking at this just to say that, yep, it was we could just have a ball tell us that he went across. So I'm wondering if it's like, if we're going to spend this much time to get it exactly right, we might as well just use a device that tells you exactly where it is, which is different than, as you said, different than calling penalties. It's like, it's not like the whole thing's going to become AI electronic. It's just, I think if there was one thing that made sense to do electronically, it was the ball crossing first down, because it is always kind of just like, ref runs up and kind of guesses where he is and places the ball down, and you're kind of like, well, that's not where he was. It seems like every other player, like,
you've already got those guys out there saying the ball's magnetic, so
yeah. Remember that whole fiasco where they accidentally revealed on Twitter that there was a chip in the ball?
Yeah.
And that's how they knew, like, how many yards people were like, wait a second. You did not, this is not known. So maybe since then they're like, all right, you know, let's just make it official now.
I mean, that would make a lot of sense to also get the speed of the runner. Like,
yeah. Yeah, that kind
you
of stuff.
You can't just get that looking at them on TV. There's no way.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess you could, but that'd be a lot more math, and they couldn't get it as fast as they do.
Yeah, they wouldn't do it as fast. No. No, I love it. I think it's a smart. I have a feeling they're going to do it in preseason. It's going to work. I just don't really see any downsides beyond just like it gets janky electronically, but then they would probably just abandon it. You know what I mean? They'd probably just be like, oh, it's messing up. Okay, just go to the ref because we don't know. Like, I don't really see a
situation. Wait, he's messing up too. Oh, dang it.
Yeah. Well, maybe in the deep future, there'll be problems of like hacking where it's like, you know, some deep, you know, Ravens fan hacker went in and like, it's like, oh, it's actually a touchdown. Yeah.
Touchdown. Oh, no, it's not. What happened? The ball deflated. And
it's like Ferris Bueller where the number goes down from missing 9 days to missing four because he hacked the system. It's going to be like first down, second down, third down. Wait, what?
What? What?
But yeah, I hope they do it.
Fair enough. Yeah, I'm there. I mean, like you said, I kind of feel like it's already there. So we'll see.
Yeah.
We'll see. All right. Going into the NBA, and man, I called game seven on everything in the conference semifinals, and I think it was just the Thunder and the Mavs that went six, right? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody else went seven, and then the Celtics obviously won 4-1.
Yep.
But, I mean, the other two went seven, and really, kudos to the Mavs. Like you said, I mean, they came up big, and then the Thunder, I mean, they were just barely, 1 point away from going seven making that a big series, but Mavericks pulled it out. They're playing.
Are you a pseudo OKC adopter? That's kind of big in Joplin.
I mean,
some are, but
you know, when you were here, I mean, I kind of leaned towards the Mavs too because
you had a hat.
Nowitzki was awesome, but Thunder too. I mean, they offered me free stuff, so yeah, I'm going to be a fan of that. Why not?
I mean, the main thing is Missouri. It's like Kansas City needs an NBA team. That'd be bigger. But I knew a lot of people growing up that definitely like, oh, finally we have somewhat of a local NBA team, even though it's like an 8-hour drive. It's not like you're driving there on the weekend or anything.
Yeah.
But there are, I mean, a lot of things people have said. Well, two things. If you're an OKC fan listening to this, they are a young team that has like lots of cap space and picks to really make this team awesome.
Yeah.
And we're really, really good. On the other hand, I do think the Mavericks were just a better team than them in this series.
Yeah,
I don't think it was just a matter of like the OKC was more talented, but they're young, so they messed up, and that's how the Mavs won. There might have been a few moments, but I think in general, the Mavs just had control. Like, they've just figured things out at the end of the season and we just had control of the series.
Yeah.
And I think regardless of youngness, I think they just had their number. And it'll be interesting going into the, you know, when they played the Timberwolves, because it's a different matchup. But for OKC.
What are your thoughts on that game coming up tomorrow? Or, well, today, tonight?
What is the second? I'm looking live. The Pacers are up 3 with 20 seconds left, and they have the ball.
Yeah.
Let's go, Pacers.
I think they'll end up pulling that out. I mean, we pre-record this, guys. Don't worry. We pre-record this. It's been noted.
Yeah, they know. That people, if you're listening to this, you know the result. But, Jason Tatum dismissed. Now Miles Turner of the Pacers just rebounded. So now the Celtics will have to foul with 10 seconds left. Holy cow.
Well,
this would be a bad loss for the Celtics if they lose.
I mean, if the Pacers, make those two free throws, then
I think it should pretty much
be in hand.
If they make both, it should be in hand, which again, that'd be a bad loss for the Celtics.
But Mavericks, Timberwolves, I mean, before this one finishes up here, what are your thoughts on that series? I mean, I know you're a Dallas fan, but do you think the Timberwolves can make it or?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. If I'm being objective, I understand why most people are probably picking the Timberwolves. I mean, it's hard to watch that Nuggets game and just see them running 100 miles per hour. Like they're the most athletic guys in the world. Like it's Space Jam. And they're just blah, 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 getting everything done. It's hard to be like, okay, now they're going to lose to the Mavericks. But if you're getting really nitty gritty, I think the Timberwolves were literally built to beat the Nuggets.
Yeah.
They're like, we're going to have two huge guys. Their star is a huge guy and Jokic. We know how to combat him. Aaron Gordon can't get his thing going whenever Rudy Gobert's down there. He's not a shooter. So it makes things tough. That's a different animal than the Mavericks. Even if the Mavericks aren't technically better than the Nuggets, I think they're a better matchup for the Timberwolves in terms of Luka's a point guard. He's not down low, like handling Rudy Gobert. He can throw it to guys open in the three. Rudy Gobert doesn't know where to go. I think it'll be interesting. I understand why it's not like, oh my God, the Mavericks are going to destroy him. I mean, it's like they are very talented. I mean, they traded 7 picks for Rudy Gobert, so you better hope so.
When's the last time the Timberwolves were relevant? And was that when
2004.
Garnett was there, right?
Yeah, 2004. They lost in the Western Conference Finals to the Lakers. So, yeah. I mean, they haven't been good, like not even close to being good. This is a big, that's why it's tough to be like, it's funny when these teams become good, but they're for the season, it feels like they're good for so long.
Yeah.
That it feels like you're taking down a giant and the Timberwolves. But meanwhile, if you're a fan of them, it's like, oh my God, I've never won in my lifetime. And now we just lost the Mavericks. So I feel for them in terms of like, I wouldn't be mad if they won. It's not like losing to the Spurs or something.
Speaking of feeling, how about the Knicks when they had their entire all franchise team there just watching? And then they're like all hyped up in the first half and then they start losing and they all sit down. Patrick Ewing was there and he's just like, "Oh, we suck." But yeah, I would hate to have that happen. Go there, be the like guest of honor. Oh man, we're gonna win this series, and then we're done.
Yeah,
wow. But all right, Celtics Pacers. Thoughts on this series? Does it go 7, or you think it goes less?
Oh man, I don't know. So this is again, people listening know the result, but according to this thing, anyways. So we thought they were gonna shoot 2 free throws, right? But I guess on the inbound they turned it over. So now the Celtics called timeout, and they have a chance to tie it with a 3, unfortunately. So if you're listening to this and you're a Celtics fan, you're probably happy because they have a chance to tie this, get away scot-free, and then probably win the game in 5 games.
We know why you're not here, Jensen. We know. We're taking names. I got my pen here. We're taking names.
I mean, they have a chance to tie it.
They do.
Unfortunately. It should have been over. I guess they turned it over on the inbounds. How do you do that? So I almost... he made a 3. No. All right. So now the Pacers have the ball with 5 seconds left. This is like, it's almost like the result of this game will give my answer to your question.
Let's go.
Wow. Jaylen Brown hit it. They turned it over. All right. So hopefully Halliburton hits a game winner here, but we'll see after the timeout. In general, like this game though is kind of going how, I don't think the Pacers are like can win the championship, but they have the shooting to beat the Celtics, who, well, again,
ESPN just took away those points on my end. So,
no, mine says Jaylen Brown 3. That'd be funny. We messed up. He actually didn't hit it.
Sorry, he missed. All right.
But that's
fair enough. I'm good with that. I would like to see it go 7 just for viewership, but it may not. It may not. And, more viewership issues, and we go to the PGA Tour, and we talk golf, and, the Scottie Scheffler thing going on. Reports came out Friday last week of the pro number one golfer, and he was arrested at the site of the PGA Championship. It was announced yesterday that there is an international investigation going on. They wanted to let the public know and just kind of get that out there. And if the policies are not being followed and actions will be taken is kind of where they're at now. Because, I mean, the LMPD confirmed that the officer failed to activate his body cam before Scheffler was stopped, handcuffed, and arrested. And, that's not normal protocol there. And that's going to get you in big trouble. So now they've got those... actions being taken to see if everything was justifiable. And the officer in his statement said that he gave instructions to stop and the SUV accelerated, dragged him, causing injuries to his wrist and knees, which resulted in him assaulting the officer. and getting him booked. And I mean, with all that being said, if they don't have the camera footage to prove anything, and like, what's he being held there for? And how are they going to hold on to him when it's an international investigation? Police said that Thursday this week, so tomorrow for you guys that are listening today, that's going to be the day that they're going to announce everything and explain everything that's going on. And I mean, that's crazy that that happened. I mean, it's really weird to watch. He was in traffic trying to get to the PGA spot that he needed to get to, and there was a wreck up ahead, and then they caught up to him, and he tried to like just go with traffic. I don't know. There's a lot of stuff going on. No body cam footage, so can't really understand the entity of that. So,
yeah, I didn't really follow it, but it seems like a funny situation that, but to just get out of it and then play.
Yeah,
knowing most of how these situations go, but
absolutely. I mean, there's just a lot of uncertainty going on there. And like, I don't even know. Like, I wish they would just tell us what really was going on. Like, obviously they've done some digging and they know it's international and stuff that's happening. So it's a little funky to me.
Yeah.
Little funky.
Ooh. Let's get funky.
How'd that game turn out for you? Overtime?
It's an overtime.
Dun, dun, dun. Well, speaking of overtime, we'll go ahead and extend this a little bit and go in the MLB and talk Royals. And, I mean, their turnaround this season so far, knock on something wood over here. Yeah. It's fantastic. I mean, like, a game and a half out of first place. They're doing everything that they can. They're doing everything right. Hitters out of nowhere, like we were talking beforehand, you didn't even know most of these guys until this year. And it's like, because at the beginning of the season last year, they all got hurt. And kudos to them. They're doing fantastic. They're doing a great job. They went out and got the veteran pitching that I thought that they needed. I did an article over that myself. I don't remember if I published it or not, but I know that I talked about it on the show. And it really, ironically, they had the 2014 World Series team in town last week. And I mean, it really reminds me of the DNA of that 2014 World Series team. I mean, right now they're in prime position for a wild card spot. So we're the Cardinals, by the way. The Cardinals are, I said that they would make the playoffs, and if they did, it would be in a wild card spot. The Cardinals are two, three games out right now of the wild card spot, and we're like almost 50 games into the season. So,
yeah,
crazy to think that we're already almost 50 games in. Crazy.
Yeah, third of the way. It seems like, from what you said, so it was just one of those things where it's like, they were injured last year. And they had did they change GMs at all?
Yeah. Or JJ Piccolo. They went from Dayton Moore to JJ Piccolo.
And when was that?
Last season, beginning of last year. They got the new manager last year too, because they dropped Matheny.
So maybe this guy knows his stuff and it just didn't pan out last year because of injuries. But
absolutely.
Because like you said, sometimes you just need that veteran pitcher, even if he's not the best. You just need, like you said, that 2015 team was very Moneyball.
Absolutely.
You know that kind of thing where it's like there's not like, the guy that's the absolute all-star, but just kind of putting together some pieces.
Enough leadership.
Though I do see, it does seem like I see a retweet from Mahomes about Bobby Witt, whoever that is, about every other game. So he must be doing somewhat good.
Oh, they're BFFs and the royalty of the town. So,
yeah. Well, he's the owner of the team. I guess it's true. This is probably good news for him. But I love it. I feel like it's better when a Missouri team's good in the playoffs for the MLB, and we might get both. But the Royals especially, I feel like it feels fresher because it's so rare that they're like a good team that for them to be back. I mean, they're only
been a while since we've had some consistency. I mean, you got the Royals right now that are decent. Again, knock on wood. Then you have the Chiefs that won the Super Bowl, and then you got the Kansas City Current who are continuing to dominate. And
are they?
I mean, they haven't lost yet, but they do have draws and they do have wins, and their winning streak at home came to an end this last week. but they were able to stay in first place. They were able to grab a point on the table, and they currently lead the NWSL and are number one in the league. So, I mean, that's going to be a team to continue to watch through the summer to see where they go. If they don't make the playoffs at this point, that is going to be the biggest
drop
I've seen in a long time. I mean, they've played so well this year.
Wow.
And they haven't lost a game. So
that's crazy.
It's been really fun to watch.
Yeah. I said it's that Mahomes touch. He touches every good part of Kansas City right now.
He stepped out there on opening day, and him and his wife got the stadium put together. And
yeah,
I mean, like the commissioner said,
their only stadium, right?
Yeah,
the only women's soccer stadium. And he's not involved with Sporting, is he?
Yeah,
he's
the owner of Sporting too.
Is he really?
Yeah,
he just has his hand in like every team.
When he got his contract, he invested in every team.
Yeah, he loves sports, man. He's always like retweeting about golf, retweeting about NASCAR. Like he seems like he watches everything.
Yeah,
which is truly the heart of a champion, I guess.
I mean, his dad was a country boy. Like he grew up in Texas and he watched NASCAR and all that stuff. So
I guess so. It's just funny how he's just every like literally anytime there's like a game going on, I'll see a tweet from Holmes like, "Wow." Like really,
even golf, he's got his hand in golf too, because him and Travis Kelce have that tournament that they go to.
To the point where I won't even know what he's talking about. He'll just be like, "Holy cow!" And I'm like, "What is this?" And I'll look it up, and it's like a Premier League game or something. And it's like, God, he watches everything.
He is friends with Ryan Reynolds, who owns Wrexham, so
it's possible. But I think in general, he just loves watching any sport, like any sport that's on that's competitive, especially when you're in that realm of him where it's like, he's the best at his sport. It probably feels good to be like, now let's watch Leo Messi do his thing, blah, blah.
I mean, they did shake hands, and when I was there, they told me I had to get out of the tunnel so they could have their little meet and greet. Got yelled at, and I was just like, I'm sorry. I didn't know I wasn't supposed to be here. I didn't know this is where he was coming. I apologize.
We got a photo shoot coming.
Yeah.
This is big.
You can't ban me. Actually, I can ban you. Okay.
You know who I am. You're in the Sports Time Out podcast.
No, my name's Tony Caronco. T-O-N-Y.
We miss you, Tony. We miss you, Tony. But I'm glad there's just the final segment.
Exactly, yeah.
Okay. I'm glad we need more of these.
We need more of these suckers.
Ooh.
Right, yeah, double.
We need
to get my third one coming in this summer, yeah.
We didn't talk much about the Chiefs in terms of we're just talking about the bad news of Rasheed, but I am so in on this three-peat. I think every fan is. Like, this is such a cool feeling right now.
Yeah.
I keep going and watching the highlights of the Ravens game, and I'm just bad. Like, it's so I tell people, I recommend your team winning the Super Bowl, because it's so that's the fun part. Because it's almost like, I'm not sure if you're the same, but my anxiety can be bad enough to, the week up to a game, it's not like what you see on commercials where it's like, yeah, there's wings and we're all laughing. It's like, I'm just like a stress ball. That's like, oh my God, if we lose to the Bills, then they're going to say Allen's better than Mahomes. It's like, I'm just a stress. And then afterwards when we win, that's the fun part where I rewatch
shut up, go home. It's not the Bills time. No. Told you he wasn't better.
It's so much more fun. So I take advantage of every moment. It's like, I love this. Even though it's the dead time of NFL right now, technically, because it's just, it's a couple OTAs and they're going, this is my favorite time, which is kind of watch the replays. People talk about how we're the defending champs again, and now we're going for a three-peat. So I'm all in on Chiefs. It's so much fun right now.
Poor Drew Bledsoe taking all those beatings when he was a Bill and then went to the Patriots and took a beating by Tom Brady. And
yeah.
Glad he got to vent a little bit at the roast the other day. So.
Oh, yeah, that was good. That's good.
But, yeah. Well, on that note, we'll go ahead and head to the local sports update brought to you by Trackside Burgers. They're open at 1515 West 10th Street. Go get one of Chef Mike's specialties the rest of this week and through the weekend. Man, it's hard to say that when we're doing a midweek show. And weekend high school baseball action. We have back-to-back district champ Webb City as they beat CJ this past Monday at MSSU, and they'll head to Kearney to play in sectionals Saturday. Stay tuned to times and where the games will be. And then in the two-minute warning brought to you by Hot Stone Pizzeria, not feeling like cooking this weekend, go grab some chicken bacon ranch pizza this weekend. That's my favorite. You can also try their meatza and all that kind of stuff. I mean, they got some really good, especially the cheese bread too. I mean, I'm getting real hungry here. Too bad I'm going to be out of town this weekend and not be able to go get any. But yeah, on that note, congrats to Diamond on winning the state championship in softball class 2A. And good job to LT out there, Grace Frazier. We had them on the show this year for basketball, and unfortunately basketball didn't pan out, but softball did. So congrats to them.
Congrats.
On a really good season and a championship season at that. One of them a senior and one of them a junior. So not too bad to end your senior year and junior year. So
respect.
But on that, the music's here. So is the end of another episode for Tony, Jensen, Clint, Jonah, and myself. Have a great and safe weekend, and make sure you get some ghetto tacos before your games this weekend, or before you head out of town, or whatever. I mean, you got plenty of time. You got Thirsty Thursday coming up now. You got Friday, 10% burritos, our normal special that they got going. If you can't get in there this week, make sure you get in and grab some breakfast burritos throughout the week as well. I mean, got till Saturday on those, and be sure to get some food at the food truck Friday coming up, I believe this week or next week. I know it's close, weather pending, but got any end of the week plans this week?
I'm doing a big very LA. I'm gonna be shooting a film. So I mean, my own film, not like a Hollywood film or anything. So I've been doing that. So I've been prepping. Yep, doing a film with Tom Cruise. I mean, he's in my film, a little short film I'm doing. So that's gonna be cool. A lot of him running around. Nope, I'm doing that. And then
Me. Get away from me. I'm gonna call the cops.
It's all that, but that's part of the film. It's us talking to the cops. Nope, a lot of that. And then doing watching the Mavericks, and it should be fun. Hopefully, it seems like there's no tornadoes in Joplin, so.
No joke. Good thing I'll be out of here. We'll be in Amarillo for graduation, so we're going to go out there. Shout out Max Preston. We're going to try to meet up out there. That's where he lives now. He joined our show for a few episodes while he was here, and a long story. But he's out in Amarillo now, and he's doing the sports broadcasting over there on their TV station. So kudos to him, and good job out there, too. Really excited. Miss him here, but yeah. Anyway, early show, heading to Texas, and not to see the Rangers, though, unfortunately, because,
But maybe the Mavericks will be in town. See you, everybody.
Absolutely.
Sports time out.
Oh, wait. That's copyrighted.
Yeah, I got to think of a new one.
Edit that. Nope. See you next week. Bye.